Hi everybody, here we are finally getting to our digestive video. Video for digestion. Thank you for your patience. Ironically enough, I just had breakfast, so I'm gonna have to really take it easy with the yoga for digestion. So the idea of the yoga for digestion is not just your physical body digesting, but also your ability to digest the things that happen in your life, to digest life in general. So let's start sitting. You can find a comfortable seat on a bolster. We're gonna start with a little bit of pranayama, a little bit of a breath work. So when you're sitting for doing breath work, you wanna find a supportive seat where your spine can sit up a little bit tall so that your spine is aligned and your energy centers are all in a line as well. And this is a right nostril breathing, so it's a Surya breath. It's a sun breath. So we're going to be breathing in and out through the right nostril. So if you want to make pranayama mudra, you can tuck the middle finger and forefinger down into the palm and then use the thumb to close off the left nostril. Sorry, the ring finger to close off the left nostril. So we're going to be breathing through the right nostril. You can also use any other finger for that and I'll guide you through. So if at any time you don't feel comfortable or you feel short of breath, feel free to just release the practice and rest your hands on the knees and breathe naturally. Okay, so sitting up nice and tall, we'll start just with our natural breath. So you're welcome to close eyes if you want to or keep them open with a soft gaze. And just taking a couple of breaths in and out through the nose in a natural way. Inhaling and exhaling. And then when you're ready, you can close the left nostril and inhale through right. And exhale through right. So very simply, inhaling and exhaling. Smooth and steady through right nostril. And this is to stimulate the digestive fire or the fire element in the body. So we can do 5 to 6 rounds or up to 10 if you want to, this right nostril breathing. When you're finished, exhaling through right nostril and then release the hand and breathe again through both nostrils, just noticing any changes or shifts or feelings. Good. Okay. So we're going to start with a little seated twist here. So let's start by inhaling and reaching arms up towards the ceiling, stretching up tall. We'll exhale and twist to the right side. And drawing the spine up tall, relax the shoulders. And just softly turning the head. Take a couple of breaths here. And when you're ready to inhale, reach your arms up and untwist. Stretch up tall again, lengthening. And we'll exhale and twist to the other side. Breathe. Always breathe. And on your next inhale, reaching up to center again. We'll exhale, hands to the heart. If there's any intention that you want to bring into your practice here, feel free to do that now. And then we're going to move into a little bit of a stimulating forward bend. So have you sit up on a blanket fold or something a little lower than a bolster. So it's a little bit supportive. Sitting right on the edge. Take the feet a little bit apart, so they're a little wider than hip distance apart, and we'll do something called sort of rowing or butter churning. So you can bring your hands together, interlace your fingers. As you inhale, leaning forward. As you exhale, lean back, squeeze the belly in. As you inhale, coming forward. My pancakes are in there going, hey, what are you doing? Exhaling as you're coming back. Doing that with breath, you can follow your own breath rhythm, inhaling forward to wherever you're comfortable and then exhaling back. And if you like, you can take that around in a circle like you're churning a big vat of butter, inhaling forward, exhaling back. Change the direction, go the other way, exhaling back, inhaling forward. So I don't recommend doing this after breakfast or after a big meal. That's not my recommendation. You always want to practice on an empty stomach, not just this sequence, but anytime you do yoga, if possible. Okay, and we're going to come back to center. And release the hands down. Okay, we'll take the shoulders up to the ears and roll them down the back. Okay, so then we're going to come to sitting on a bolster, sort of hero style. So you can be straddling the bolster so that you've got one foot on either side. And feel free to sit in hero pose without a bolster too, if it's comfortable for you. You can sit just there. And then we're going to take a little side bend. So when you reach your right arm up, inhale, stretch up tall. Exhale and lean a little to the left, reaching that right hand up. And we'll just take a couple of breaths here. You can sort of press your right hip down as you reach your right hand up. Keeping the heart a little bit lifted, find your breath. I'm just going to see how it feels on the bolster here. It's a little bit further to the ground down here, so you might have a hand on a block or a phone book. When you're ready to inhale, reach both hands up. Lengthen, stretch tall. Exhale the other side. Reaching with the left hand. So you're looking for that stretch in the left side body. Breathe. Almost like we're creating space, reaching, creating space in the belly. And then when your inhale comes, reach both hands up. Exhale, hands down to the left side, we'll twist. Sorry, right side, we'll twist. So I'm mirroring you. I think that's how it will work in the video too. You twist to the right, I'm twisting to the left. So we'll be doing a lot of twists and forward bends to stimulate the digestion today as part of our practice. Fire is getting hot. When you're ready to inhale, come back to center. Exhale to the other side. Keeping the heart lifted, shoulders soft, jaw relaxed. Nice long breath. That was my brother. We locked him out while we're shooting the video. He just came to the window and I was like, mm-mm. Okay, so then we're going to take a version of child's pose that is a little bit different than we normally do. So we're still going to take, actually, for this one, keep the knees a little bit closer together. And what you might want is a block or a bolster under your forehead, because with the knees together, it's a little harder to bring the head all the way down to the mat, especially if you've got any kind of belly. So this is one that's really good for stimulating the Agni, or the digestive fire in the belly. Agni is fire, Sanskrit. So what we're gonna do is take our thumbs and put them inside the palm and wrap the fingers around the thumbs. And then bring the knuckles and the fists right to the navel, right to the navel center. Then we're gonna get really tall, lengthen the spine. Take a big inhale here, and then exhale and fold over the hands. You can rest the forehead on the bolster or the block or the floor if it reaches. And we'll stay there for a few breaths. So staying in that child's pose. Now check in if there's any kind of pain in that area of the abdomen. Just please release the hands. So any kind of discomfort or pain, taking the fists away and just doing it with the arms beside. Remember to continue to breathe. We'll stay here for a few more breaths, but you're welcome to release at any time at all. Good, nice. And then when you're ready, go ahead and walk yourself up, slowly coming back up, take the hands away. Good, and we'll move our props out of the way and come into a forward bend. So forward bend with feet parallel, hip distance apart. You're gonna have a bend in the knees here, tucking the belly in and resting the ribs on the thighs. So again, when that belly is tucked in, it's closer to the digestive fire. It's kind of like standing close to the fire. The heat is really good for the digestion. So then the upper body can just hang, keeping the knees a little bit bent, and let the head and neck hang down here. Take a few breaths. And if at any time that's not comfortable, you can bend the knees and just rest the elbows on the thighs. Good, and then with your next inhale, reach arms up, come all the way up to standing. Exhale, hands to heart. Good. Now when I taught this in class a couple of weeks ago, we did something called Noli. Noli?
Noli.
Noli? That was my master pronunciator there. So this is an action, and he's probably going to laugh at me when I do this, but it's an action of drawing the belly in and up underneath the rib cage. So you're sort of hollowing the belly out. And there's lots of variations of it too that we can do, but we're just going to start with the first one. And it's quite hard to see. I actually recommend people Google it and have somebody with their shirt off, a man, so you can actually see what it looks like. But what we do is we bend the knees, rest your hands on your knees. And again, this is optional. You're going to exhale all the way out. Empty the lungs completely. And then with the exhale held out, you're going to draw, suck the belly in and up, trying to hollow out the navel. Drawing the navel in and up underneath the rib cage. So something we used to play with when I was a little kid. I don't know why. Experimenting. Good, and then gently release the belly and inhale. Come all the way up to standing. So again, you couldn't see anything that was going on there, but it's spelled N-A-U-L-I. And if you Google it, you can get somebody with their shirt off and you can actually see the motion. So you exhale, but knees bent, exhale all the way to the bottom of the exhale, then hold the exhale out while you pull the belly in. You might hold for three counts or even two, and then just release gently inhaling. And now we're going to just swing the arms here. So just kind of letting the arms flail to the sides. Again, a little bit of twisting action. And you can actually let the hands swing around and kind of bang on the kidneys at the back a little bit. Some of these movements are part of a sequence that I learned in the ashram for constipation. So we'll be doing a couple of those as part of this practice. They have a whole sequence for it, and you drink a bunch of salt water, and Bob's your uncle. Okay. All right, so we're gonna make our way back down to the floor. So you can come facing the front of the mat, We can flow together if you want. Inhale, reach arms up. Exhale, swan dive, forward fold. Inhale, step back to hands and knees. And we're gonna lower all the way down to the belly and come into swimmer. Actually, let's do a little lunge first. Let's take the right foot forward. We'll inhale, reach arms up. And then exhale, twist to the right side. You can rest the hand on the knee and the hip, drawing the belly in to create length in the spine, and just softly turning the head. The other variation, of course, if it's comfortable, is to wrap the elbow, still squeezing in the navel, and come into prayer hands. Not doing that because there's banana pancakes in there. So take a couple of breaths here. And then when you're ready, we'll come back to center and just gently change sides. You can throw in a downward dog there if you want to, and then bring in the left foot forward. And take hands up, reaching arms up high, and then twisting to the left side. Taking a few breaths, relax the shoulders. And when you're ready, back to center. Now we'll come down to the belly. So keep breathing here. You can just gently lower down. And we're gonna come into a swimmer pose. So swimmer, one version is to reach arms forward, toes pointing straight back. It's like a slow motion swimming person. So when you inhale, you're gonna raise head, right leg, right arm, left leg, and then exhale, back down. Inhale, opposite, left arm, right leg. Exhale, back down. You can continue that at your own pace, inhaling opposite arm to leg, spread fingers, spread toes, exhale and come back down. And just keep going, alternating left and right. Inhaling up, exhaling down. Just continuing with your own breath. We'll do the last side, which is left hand, right leg. So we've done an even number on each side. And then come back down to rest. Good. And then let's come into Funky Cobra. So actually, let's come into Sphinx first. So elbows under shoulders, forearms parallel to each other. Toes pointing straight back. Good. And remember, if your low back feels a little bit pinchy here, try pressing the toes down, feeling the knees lift, and then try picking up a rib off of the floor, pulling the navel in. If that doesn't take care of that pinching in the low back, just try coming down a little lower. Good. So from here, we're going to do a little twist. So you'll inhale, head here in the center, exhale, gently turn to the side, wherever is comfortable. Looking over one shoulder, inhale, back to center. Exhale, twist to the other side. Inhale, center. And do that a few times with our own breath, exhaling a little twist. Inhaling, center. Do one more on each side, finishing on the left is the last one. Inhaling back to center, and then we're gonna rest a moment, head on the hands. If you want to, you can windshield wiper the feet. And relaxing the feet back down. Let's take a Funky Cobra. So we're gonna bring hands out to the sides beside the shoulders on fingertips. So the hands are tented. The forehead will rest straight down on the floor. And then we're going to take attention to the toes. You're going to spread your toes and press your toenails down. Feel your knees lift. Press your pubic bone down, which is a tailbone scoop.
So it's
toes down, pubic bone down, shoulders up, and then inhale it. So you're using your back and then adding a little bit with the hands, making sure that the low back feels comfy, not pinching at all. Take a couple of breaths. You could be here, that's good too. And then gently release. Come back to head resting on the hands. Feel free to jiggle out the hips or make any movement to release the low back. So again, all of those belly poses massage, kind of massage the abdomen in addition to the forward bends and the twists. So you notice we've done a nice mix of side bends, forward bends, twists, and back bends just now. So let's make our way back up into, well, let's do another twist, shall we? I'm like trying to follow my plan here. So let's do a laying twist here. What we'll do is take arms out to the sides. Bring your, confused about what I'm doing. Forearms on the floor. Sphinx pose. Left hand's going to go underneath the right arm. Left hand under right arm. Slide your right knee up beside your hand and then gently roll over onto your back. So the knee might hover off of the floor. The right arm opens up to the right side and you're finding your way into a little twist there. And you'll notice when you bring your right shoulder down, the knee will lift. That's okay, you can let it do that. You can squeeze the belly in here. You might play with it a little bit, bringing the knee down, feeling the stretch in the shoulder and the pec, and then bringing the shoulder down. And this arm can be straight or bent, whatever you like. I'm just running out of space because of the fire here. So then we're gonna roll back to the belly. Slowly with control and change sides. So this time the right arm is going to thread under. Left knee comes up by the hand. And then opening this out to the side. So again, as this shoulder moves down, the knee will want to pop up. Just squeezing the belly a little bit to support the low back. And you might play with it a little bit there. Knee goes down. Feel a bigger stretch here, so you get a nice deep breath. Shoulder goes down, knee comes up a little. Good. And let's roll back to the belly, same way we came. Maybe a moment in crocodile, just taking a few breaths here. So just a couple more forward bends and twists and then we're into our restoratives. So let's make our way into a child's pose here. Squeeze the belly and gently press up. Taking the knees a little bit apart and finding your child's pose that you like. Take a couple of ha breaths here. Inhale, big breath through the nose. Open the mouth and sigh the exhale out. When you're ready, walk your way up from child's pose. Take the feet to the side and come to sitting. Good. So again, you could pull a blanket in underneath the hips. A little bit more comfortable. Widen the sit bones. We're going to come into Paschimottanasana, forward bend. Paschima means west side of the body, and that's the back side of the body, so it's a back side of the body stretch, a west side. So widen sit bones, flex your feet, spread your toes. We'll start by sitting up nice and tall. Actually, let's come into this a slightly different way. I'm always changing my mind on the fly. So we're going to bring the feet in a little bit, bend the knees. You're going to reach for the outer edges of your feet. You could also reach for the big toes and hook your peace fingers around the big toes. That's sort of a more traditional way. And so either one is good. And then we're going to start to slowly bring the feet forward. So you're sliding the feet forward to wherever your body goes to. This keeps the back nice and flat. And you can notice we get all this nice compression in the abdomen. It's the squeezing, massaging in the digestive system. So just go to wherever your body will take you. Could be here. This could be your pose right here. Knees are still bent and it's as far as we go. Just tucking the chin a little so you get length up the back of the neck. That stretch all the way up the west side of the body. Go to wherever it is that your body will happily go to and take three deep breaths. So inhaling and exhaling. Feel free to breathe out through the mouth. Finish off this with one big honeybee, a Brahmari breath. So that's the humming sound with the little gap between the upper and bottom set of teeth. So big inhale, fill the lungs. Gently walk our way back out. And we'll finish with one seated twist. So you can cross the right leg over. I'm not mirroring anymore. So my right leg, your right leg, cross the right foot over. So the right foot's flat on the floor. Flex that left foot so it's active. Press your left thigh down. Interlace the fingers and grow tall. Touch the ceiling with the top of your head. When you're ready to inhale, reach your right arm up. And exhale over the right shoulder. Take a couple of breaths here. And then gently release, come back to center. And we'll change sides. So I'm stretching left leg out, crossing the right leg over. Sorry, left leg over. Inhale, reach the left arm up. Exhale, twist to the left side. Belly draws in, but shoulders and face are soft. And one more breath here. And gently inhale back to center. Great. Okay, so we're going to set up for a couple of restorative poses. And surprise, surprise, they're forward bends and twists. So what we'll do is grab a bolster. And if you're at home and don't have bolsters, you can use pillows. Like we've got a couple of giant pillows here. You can use folded blankets, like a couple of these, on one on top of each other. So a couple of pillows from your bed, which are kind of lengthways, that would also work. So what you're doing is just creating the same sort of support that you would get from the bolster. That being said, for this one, because we're doing a seated forward bend with it, what you could do, you're sitting on one blanket, widening the sit bones, and this can be done with knees bent as well, especially if you have low back issues, okay? So if you're doing it with knees bent, you're gonna create support for your upper body to rest against. So if you have a bolster, you might be leaning it, folding forward on it that way. You could have the feet together and folding forward on it that way. If you have blankets, just keep stacking blankets until you've got something to rest your head on. So we all have a different height, so you're gonna go to play around with it. So I'll give you some time to set that up. Pillows, blankets, all of that jazz. If you're doing the feet straight, you're going to find some kind of a position where you can rest your head. So just keep stacking, keep stacking until you get that wherever your body is meeting you today, yeah? And then we'll be here for about 5 minutes. Feel free to make any adjustments at any time. Make sure you're comfortable. And then it's all about letting go. So when you're set up, coming into your breath, taking a couple of deep inhales and sighing out the exhale, letting go anything that's sticking to you that you don't want to have stuck to you anymore. You just want to be free of that. Breathe it out. Let it go. Just allow your soft back body to melt towards your soft front body. Allow the jaw to go slack, the tongue, the throat, the whole lower part of your face. Allow the forehead to soften, the lips to soften. Just allow yourself to be here for a moment with your breath. Softening. Time you can guide yourself out if it doesn't feel good in any way for any reason. Slowly, very gently make our way out with helping hands. Just slowly roll your spine up, vertebra by vertebra. Head and neck can unroll last. You might take the shoulders back, open the chest, and maybe take a little back bend here just to counter that forward bend. If it feels good, you can bend your knees and make a little windshield wipers. And then we'll set up for a restorative twist. So again, the twist has that sort of squeeze and soak effect on the internal organs. So if you think, they often use an analogy of a washcloth, like a dishcloth that has dirty water in it. And when you squeeze it out, when you twist, you squeeze all the dirty water out, you squeeze the blood, actually squeezes out of the organs. And then when you untwist, the organs fill up with this fresh oxygenated blood. So increasing circulation, blood flow, and nutrients to the internal organs and the digestive system. Sounds good? So we'll set up our twist with a one bolster. And you can sit with the right hip touching the bolster first, because often we'll twist to the right side first when we're doing yoga. The idea being that we massage the ascending colon first, especially when you're doing twists that require some compression in the belly. So you twist to the right, you get massage in the ascending colon, and then when you twist to the left, you get massage in the descending colon. So it's helping your digestive system to move in the direction that it's designed to move in. Pretty cool technology. So we'll start with feet in sage twist. So the top ankle on the resting of the arch of the bottom foot. And you're gonna turn towards the bolster, get tall. So you want that length in the spine, belly drawing in to create length and space. Create your twist first, turning the front body towards your bolster. And then go ahead and walk your front body down. And you could have head on the hand center or head to the side, whichever is comfortable. You could also have a block underneath your bolster, which makes it a little less strong. So if you want to prop up the bolster with a block or some kind of a phone book. I don't know if anyone has phone books anymore. And we'll be here for about 5 minutes. So just get comfortable. If you find the twist is too much, try shifting your hips away from the bolster a little. Once you're on it, shifting hips away. So just settling in. So you can take glasses off. Find your breath. And you can imagine that you're breathing up and down your spine here. Imagine the breath is flowing up as you inhale, down as you exhale. Could even be breathing out through the mouth to release and soften. So allowing yourself to settle, being here and now, in this moment with your breath. You find the mind is dancing off in different directions. You can bring it back gently to rest on the breath. Giving it something to do, a task like counting the breath, or just keeping aware of the sensation of your breath. deepen your breath a little. Just oxygenating the brain, the body, all the body cells. Your exhale is cleansing. And whenever you're ready, you can, with helping hands, slowly roll your spine back up, vertebra by vertebra. You find that nice, gentle coming out slow so that the nervous system stays soft. And when you're ready, changing sides, bringing that bolster over to the left. And same setup here. Sitting side saddle with it sticking straight out from the left hip. Get tall, lengthen, grow tall, squeeze the belly, twist and turn towards the bolster, and then resting yourself down. So again, however the head and neck want to be positioned, finding what's most comfortable for you. If the twist is too much, just shifting hips away, giving yourself a nice deep breath out, perhaps a sigh, and just allowing everything to be as it is here in this moment. Restorative poses are all about relaxation and letting go, and they take practice. And relaxation takes practice. So we can use different techniques to get there more easily. Exhaling and emphasizing our out-breath a little. Keeping the mind focused in some way to the breath or to a mantra or to the music. You can soften the shoulders, the back of the heart. Relax your forehead and your temples. Feel free to adjust or shift at any time to increase your comfort. And just allowing everything to be melting and soft. Place to be, nothing to do. You don't gotta be anybody, just you. Thank you. your body feels. And when you're ready, you can guide your way back up with helping hands, rolling the spine. And we'll make our way into Shavasana for resting. So you can set yourself up, stretched out on the floor, arms and legs stretched out. If you want, put a bolster under the knees, especially if you have low back issues. So you could have that support. Perhaps a blanket over the hips for grounding or the whole body for warmth. And then just laying ourselves down. Make sure your heels are on the floor. And the palms are facing up. You can tuck the shoulders under the back or make any adjustments to get more comfortable here. And then just letting yourself go here. And relaxing into the feeling that everything is exactly as it needs to be, even in all its perceived imperfection. Allow the skin to soften on your body, and even the follicles for the hairs on your body, the hairs themselves can soften. Allow the fascia layer under the skin to melt onto the muscles. Feel all your muscles melting as well. And taking a deep breath in as you exhale, soften your muscles onto your bones. And then soften the bones themselves. Enjoy the feeling of just being without any responsibilities. Just here in the moment with your breath. Allow yourself to rest. Feel free to continue resting if you're in a nice place and you don't feel like moving. I'm going to show you a mudra for digestion. So you can stay resting and rewind the video later and watch this part if you want to. If you do want to come up to seated and practice the mudra now, start to gently invite movement back into your body, wiggling fingers, wiggling toes, and deepening the breath, refreshing, taking a little stretch, and gently bending the knees one at a time, so rolling to right side, use the right arm as a pillow for your head, fetal position, just taking a couple of breaths here, still integrating. When you're ready, use helping hands and walk your way up to sitting. Make yourself a comfortable seat. So just like with our pranayama breath practices, same with mudra, if you're doing a seated practice, sitting up on something so you get that support under the tailbone, which takes the pressure off the low back and allows us to sit tall and comfortable. This is called Pushan Mudra, and it's for digestion. And I recommend it for if you do have a bellyache, try it. Try the mudra. That's the time when it'll be most noticeable. So you may or may not notice these energetic shifts when you take the hand position. You might or you might not. And it's most noticeable when you first come into it, and then when you release it, at that moment when you're shifting, is when it's most pronounced, I guess. So very simply, the right hand is the forefinger and the middle finger. So your right hand, if you're right-handed, so it's like you're pinching, picking something up. The left hand is going to be middle finger and ring finger. So it looks like this. Now left hand, middle finger and ring finger, and right hand, middle finger and forefinger. And then with those finger pads just gently connecting to the thumb, you can rest the backs of the hands on the knees. And then just, if it's comfortable, closing the eyes. Sitting tall, relax your face, your jaw. And just notice how that feels. Take a few breaths. Any time the gesture's not comfortable physically or for any other reason, you just release the hands and put them back on the thighs. And this is Pushan Mudra. It's good for balancing digestion. Stimulates the digestive fire, creates a relaxation response. It's good for stomach upset or weak digestion. So you could hold from a minute up to 5 or 10 minutes if you wanted. And then when you're done, just releasing, place the hands on the thighs, take a couple of breaths. And you could rub the hands on the thighs to neutralize. Bring hands together at the heart. And we'll finish with one Om. So if you're home alone and you want to join me for chanting Om, you can. Or you can just listen as you like. So I'll take a deep breath in. Exhale it out. And then inhale for one Om. And free, and have good digestion. Namaste. I think I scared the cat with my Om. Thanks, everybody. I hope that you find that video helpful. let me know if you have any questions and I'm happy to help. Have a great day.